required. So let's go ahead and type in, I'm going to have Jane Doe be our user. Alias will auto-populate. So what that means is it is going to take the first letter of your first name and the first three letters of the last name, and it'll create a unique identifier, and that's what's going to show up on record. So it'll say this record is owned by J. Doe. And you can click on that, and it'll take you to their full name and their contact information usually, but this is just super helpful as a quick glance to see who owns it. Super helpful at a small company if you know everybody there too. I'm going to add just an email. This is going to be callcloudconsulting@gmail.com. Username will auto-populate. This is what you're going to use to log in. It's just going to be pretty much the same as the email. The nickname is also going to be unique. And the title, let's go ahead and add sales user. So the rest of this information is not required. Even title is not even required. So I'm just going to leave that blank. It does become pretty important if you're working with multiple companies in the same system, like if you have partners or a very large company where you have multiple departments. But if you have a small company, it's not going to be that big of a deal. I'm going to have this be a Salesforce platform user. The role, I'm going to have it be channel sales team because she is a sales user, and have her use the standard platform user. It will automatically check that she is an active user, so it'll send her an email for her to get logged in and everything. You can turn this off after you've activated and after you've saved all this. Different things we can add her as a marketing user, but because of our license, we can't. She can be an offline user, knowledge user, flow user. All these different licenses help us understand the different functionalities that might be extra that we'd have to pay for additional licenses. But I'm not going to add any of these because she does not need that. We can use debug mode for her. So it'll flag her user. So if she's having issues, this would make it easier to be able to see what's wrong with the system and why they're having issues. These are different contact informations, employee numbers. This could be really useful if you had an additional system like Workday that tracked your employees and their benefits and things, and you wanted your systems to be integrated. You can add a mailing address, single sign-on if you have that. And locale settings, this could be really important if you are in, let's say, California, but you have a user on the East Coast, probably in Washington, D.C. or New York. It would be very helpful to have them in the correct time zone. If they are not in the correct time zone, they will not see the correct timestamps. Whereas if something was done at 12 p.m. or noon-ish, on the East Coast, that would be done at 9 a.m. on the West Coast, and so it'd be a little bit different. And then we do have approver settings. This would be for approval processes, and you can add a delegated approver, a manager, and then who receives the request. We don't have any approval processes active, so I do not need to add those, but from here I can click save, and an email will be sent to this email provided, which should be for Jane Doe. It is not for her because this is a tutorial, but it'll help her to get signed on and logged into her account. From here, we have more settings that we can add, and it's mostly just login settings and the different things that you might want to have for security login settings. From here, we can also add permission sets, permission group sets, licenses, personal groups, and a bunch of other stuff. We'd also check the login history if that's important. Sometimes our licenses kind of expire depending on the different workflows that you have and processes that you have within Salesforce. So it's important that your users are logging in and be able to see that here. So that is how you create a new user within Salesforce. I hope this was helpful. If you have any questions, be sure to drop them down below in the comments and I'll get back to you as fast as possible. Be sure to like, subscribe, all those fun things, and I'll catch you in the next one.